Let's go Gleitschirmfliegen.
Wir jodeln durch das Alpenland.
Ui, 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 ui.
Das Echo von den Bergen schallt.
Ui, 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 ui.
So klingt es schon in aller Flur.
Ui, 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 ui.
Gehen wir den schönen Olmann zu. Sonnenschein, den Rucksack nehmen wir zur Hand und hinauf ins Alpenland. Wir jodeln durch das Alpenland.
Ui, 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 ui.
Das Echo von den Bergen schallt.
Ui, 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 ui.
So klingt es schon in aller Flur.
Ui, 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 ui.
Gehen wir den schönen Olmann zu. Das Edelweiß auf Felsenwand, dort ist unser Heimatland. Wir jodeln durch das Alpenland.
Ui, 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 ui.
Das Echo von den Bergen schallt.
Ui, 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 ui.
So klingt es schon in aller Flur.
Ui, 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 ui.
Gehen wir den schönen Olmann zu. Schon in aller Flur.
Ui, 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 ui.
Gehen wir den schönen Olmann zu.
Ui, 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 ui.
Stubaital was my favorite place to fly there. It was very calm and very serene, very mellow. It was a magical place for me.
That mountain looks different from this angle, doesn't it?
And you can see some early flyers have their wings laid out. There's the Elfer lift we'll be taking this morning.
Thank you.
Paul. Good morning, Paul.
Good morning. Gonna be a great day today.
Good. There's Bill. Hi, Bill.
How you doing, Dave?
Good.
You gonna fly today?
Oh yeah, looks great, huh?
Yeah.
What are you flying?
I'm flying an old bus. Old-fashioned Challenger, but at least it's reliable.
Oh yeah.
I know what to expect from it.
Jerry?
And this is 90 proof water.
So he says.
Alpenwasser.
Well, I've got a compact here. I'm going to start learning wingovers today.
All right.
at St. Andrea. Just checking out the ski lift over here.
Like I'm maybe hung up on something. It looks like it's hung up on something, doesn't it?
There goes Bill. There goes Bob.
There's kind of an uphill, side hill with a cliff in the middle, a little LZ, right next to the church. An aptly placed, you know, monument. You know, just pray after you land in thankfulness.
And there's the launch site up there. Here we are at the launch site.
Where what?
Between the straight down just before the trees.
Yeah.
It says in there, evidently coming up is where that lift is all the time.
Oh.
There goes Jerry. Woo! Clouds coming up the hill, and the valley's entirely obscured.
Boogied up the hill to the Guadalquivir launch, which is right on the rim of the bowl that's in, that is Verbier. And there was a real interesting effect to watch the air move, because every once in a while the clouds would form, the fog would blow in. You could actually see the air moving. And there was a takeoff in between cloud banks that rolled up the hill. Thank you.
Iceberg is aloft.
There goes Bill. And it's starting to rain.
Lodge, this is Dave at the golf course. I just felt a couple of drops of rain down here.
There goes Bob.
My feeling from the Alps was these tremendous power structures in terms of topography and in terms of the weather that gotta put you in your place, and that's pretty small.
An excitement point of view and a potential point of view and just the stark beauty of the place, you can't beat Fiji. See why Christian thinks it's the best place in Europe. It's that good.
One of my goals at Fiji was to get high enough to see the Alps Gletscher behind the Aegis Horn, and in order to do that you have to gain about 3,000 feet of altitude, and I was able to do that one day, and it's just unspeakably beautiful. Kristen, I think you did a great job. It was one of the greatest trips of my life. I really enjoyed it more than anything. And my wife feels the same way, and we're looking forward to doing it again.
Great group. I counted myself lucky to be able to link up with you guys, because it made the second half of the trip really good for me, because I planned, like I said, just boating around on my own, and finding a group of like-minded pilots and having a guide like Christian was just, couldn't have been better.
Thank you.
I mean, the whole attitude all over Europe that that this is a welcome thing, that having people flying in your town is good, you know, and that people don't really seem to care about being sued or waivers or any of that stuff, that ridiculous stuff. You know, that's just an absolute wonderful.
Well, all the way there, particularly the last part, because it was a long glide with no lift at all, and I didn't know if I was going to make it. I kept looking for alternate LZs, and I kept saying, I'm going to make it, I'm going to make it, I'm going to make it. And then I landed, I said, yeah, I made it. It was really a good feeling. I put it down right on the mark.
All right, friends, let's go through that identification again.
No, you're not.
Dave, tell us how.
I didn't say anything. I said, mine is the one with a little black knob on.
And then, Mel, you said.
No.
Versus the other Mel.
Oh, me.
I don't have a knob. I don't have.
Oh. Ooh, ugly wing.
If you look down that way, far away, very carefully, you can see the glacier. Can you see it? It's over that hill there. Can you see it? Point to it if you can see it. Yeah, that's good.
getting boring.
An hour. You're getting boring?
25
eating,
minutes.
Drinking and waiting.
Have another beer. You've had three already, though. Are you really going to fly?
Well, if I have another beer, I probably will. No matter what the conditions.
I like that.
Cheers.
Is that alcoholic?
Pepsi.
Oh, good one.
Yeah. It waters down.
I don't know what Paul is eating, but there were goats outside.
Labor noodle soup.
That's noodle soup. And now there's one less goat. He's going to be in trouble.
I
guess I had the video on.
Hey, guys, Bob. Ooh.